In community living, some or the other civic problem is bound to arise. Who is to solve them? In a democracy of the people, for the people, by the people, should we remain affected until the government solves them? If they solve them, we are happy that our partner schools have started to teach responsive citizenship using the experiential Disha content. Plus, they're setting up activity-based citizenship clubs, which also try and solve such issues in their neighborhood. This is a movement from apathy to ownership. Schools, the principals and teachers adopting the cause of citizenship, becoming alert to the problems around them, working with students and community, and finally, all together, attempting to solve them. HVB Academy's DSCC has written this wonderful story of change.
Now, the project was spearheaded for the entire reason that because this is our vicinity, we must keep it not only clean and neat, but also make it look very beautiful. It was called the beautification of F Road, so that when people come into F Road, there is a sense of pride. Along with the sense of pride, there's a sense of onus that you have taken active role in it.
For that, we have worked roughly for 2 years, entire 2017-2018.
So this initiative was taken by our principal ma'am that the students will go and investigate that what problems are there on the F Road. They kept suggestion boxes at places and we got inputs from the people staying here.
We formed a group of citizens. There are 20 citizens involved in it. They are from different societies on F Road.
Talking to the societies was a big challenge.
There always used to be, you know, heated dialogue between school and citizens.
But we were able to make them see the bigger reality and systematically solve the problems.
We had several meetings that were planning meetings. Teachers, students, all got together.
The students conducted a survey and met the representatives of various buildings. The foot overbridge was just outside our school gate, and we observed old citizens and small children had problem in climbing the stairs because the tiles were broken and were uneven. The railing was also broken. There were open dustbins.
There were many broken sidewalks, walls that had tobacco spits on them. We painted them and did our drawings and designs.
We had this corner where we had pigeons there, and it was creating a lot of issues.
We got the railings painted. You can see it's a yellow and black. We've taken a whitewash of all the outer walls that we had permissions from. You can see slogans. So we've taken it in 4 languages.
We took care of the trees because there were no boundary. This was in a pathetic condition. My children themselves took hammer, gunny bags, cement, bricks.
Initially, we were just permitted for 3 or 4 societies, but looking at the other work, all the societies approached us. You know, once we start with our neighborhood, then we go with the city and then we go ahead.
I was really happy. That satisfaction that came out from everyone contributing, amazing.
You really need to see the enthusiasm of the teachers and the students. The sun did not deter them. And today when we see the paintings, even when the neighbors come forward, we are happy we did it. It is our road now.
Even today, we feel that, yes, this is the sign that I put up. This is the tree that I decorated. This is the wall that I painted. So there's a sense that along with the we, there is a big I in it. When I works along with the we, miracles are possible.
Aao hum sab desh apnaye,
chalta hai ko dur badhaye,
bhavishya bachaye, bhagya banaye,
aao hum sab desh apnaye.
The theme of Desh Apnaye is also love for nation. Do not demand from government for each and everything. Let's see what I can do. And the same thing is at the heart of HVB. So from apathy to ownership, that is what is the whole journey about it.